Over 1.3 million individuals have filed their certificates of candidacy for this year's village and youth council elections. But the Philippine poll body says only a few individuals have filed their COCs in Metro Manila in the past days. The same goes in Davao Region and Cebu Province, where the period of filing COCs ended on Saturday. The Pumalik, meanwhile, expects more candidates to file their COCs today in Metro Manila and Abra. As for the election gun ban, around 170 have been arrested for violating the policy. An update now on the viral road rage incident in Quezon City. Three personnel from the Quezon City Police District facing charges over their alleged failure to protect the cyclist and the traffic altercation who dismissed with dismissed cop Wilfredo Gonzalez. The lawyer Raymond Fortun said there are lapses in how the police handle the case, including their failure to secure the CCTV footage and to file appropriate charges, complaints of oppression, irregularities, and incompetence in the performance of duties have been filed against the three. And Quezon City Mayor Joy Belmonte backed Fortun's move. She also stressed the need for the public to do what is right and to hold those in power accountable. QCPD's new director, Red Maralan, also has this reminder to the public.
Napakalaking tulong nito, ano, sapagkat alam mo naman, ang PNP, ang mga pulis, hindi naman natin talaga makover ang every nook and cranny ng lugar na ating binabantayan. Kung meron kayong nakukuha mga pictures and video ng krimen na nagaganap, ipadala niyo po yan sa amin sa PNP.
The National Economic and Development Authority allaying concerns over the nationwide price ceiling on rice. President Marcos earlier issued an executive order setting a 41 peso per kilogram piece ceiling for regular milled rice and 45 pesos for well-milled rice. Manila's top economist Arsenio Balisacan says the price cap will only be temporary and future measures will be implemented to address issues on rice production. While the price ceiling mandate on rice draws mixed reactions from agricultural groups, the group CNUT backs the measure, saying the move is fair to both farmers and consumers. It adds some rice millers vowed to deliver 41 pesos per kilogram of well-milled rice so that retailers can sell it in a higher price of 45 pesos while still complying with the price cap.
Pipili sila sa magsasaka ng nasa 23 to 25 pesos na palay para lalabas ng 38 pesos ang puuna nila para makadeliver sila ng 41 pesos sa Manila.
But the Federation of Free Farmers thinks otherwise.
Lalo pang bababa yung presyo ng mga palay. Mga 20% reduction yan in one day. Yung paper value ng kanilang ani na hindi pa inaani, bumagsak na ng 20%.
Some Philippine senators on the defensive after joining flak online for wearing West Philippine Sea shirts during the FIBA match between the Philippines and China on Saturday. Senate President Mig Zubiri and Senators Ronald De La Rosa, Bong Go, and Joel Villanueva wore matching shirts during the game, where Gilas crushed China 96-75. Filipinos online, however, called the move performative and T-shirt nationalism. Other social media users also said the senators actually have the power to do something more for the country in a more formal approach. Senator Francis Tolentino, meanwhile, defends his colleagues, saying everyone has a right to free expression, even in a FIBA game.
One way of showing their unity. Hindi po ito first time nakita nung opening game po natin sa... Yung opening po sa Philippine Arena, may mga nakasuot na gano'n eh. Kulay pula nga lang. Wala pong masama doon. Nagpapakita ng kanilang personal political beliefs. Na atin po yung West Philippine Sea, even in a sports such as the FIBA, I don't see anything wrong with that.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. heading to Jakarta, Indonesia this afternoon for the 43rd ASEAN Summit. Marcos is expected to meet with several world leaders on the sidelines of the high-profile meet. On the agenda, talks of the prime ministers of Cambodia, Timor-Leste, and Vietnam, as well as the president of South Korea. Marcos is also expected to raise China's continuing aggression in Philippine waters before the world leaders. U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris will be in attendance during the ASEAN summit in Indonesia, where she's expected to address key issues, including disputes in the South China Sea and the ongoing crisis in Myanmar. This report.
When Vice President Kamala Harris was in Southeast Asia last year, in a rebuke to Beijing, she stopped by Palawan Island in the Philippines, just 330 kilometers east of the disputed Spratly Islands in the South China Sea. In Jakarta, Indonesia, next week, to meet leaders of ASEAN, the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, Harris will also discuss this vital maritime route, where there are overlapping claims by China, Taiwan, and four ASEAN members, Vietnam, the Philippines, Malaysia, and Brunei.
You can expect the Vice President to discuss the South China Sea as well. Throughout her meetings in Jakarta, a couple of things. She will reaffirm our support for the freedom of the seas, peaceful resolution of disputes, and adherence of international law, including freedom of navigation.
Other key topics include the crisis in Myanmar, where thousands have been killed and millions displaced since the 2021 military coup. ASEAN has failed to compel its members to return to democracy, as have various international sanctions, including from the U.S.
In Myanmar, we must press the military regime to stop the violence, to implement ASEAN's five-point consensus, to support a return to democratic governance.
Harris is also expected to condemn Russia's invasion of Ukraine. As is the case with Myanmar and the South China Sea, ASEAN's reaction has been muted, expressing only concerns about the fallout of the war without denouncing Russia, a key arms supplier in the region. Some in the region will also question why it is Harris, not President Joe Biden, who is attending.
Maybe it is a slap for Indonesia because if we see Indonesia flagship program for the summit, actually in ASEAN Indo-Pacific Forum. And it will not be attended by the U.S.
Leaders meeting in Jakarta will also deal with another key challenge. The Indonesian capital has been one of the world's top most polluted cities this month as authorities grapple with a spike in toxic smog. Pat Siwida Kuswara, VOA News, Washington.